Wrestling and Reddit. Sounds like a great combination, didn't even know it exists. So in today's video, we are going to react to Squared Circle subreddit and laugh. Because I wanna laugh, and hopefully, it will make me laugh. One rule. If I see someone making fun of Primo or Brock Lesnar, I'm immediately leaving, and you know what? I'm calling the police. Hello, someone said Primo bad. In the 2001 Royal Rumble, Kane wore a mask for 54 minutes and eliminated 11 people. You can wear one in Aldi, basically in a supermarket. Yeah, don't be a puss. I was watching the news and I saw an 80-year-old woman saying, "You have to wear your mask for your own benefit." 20 seconds later, a 25-year-old is like, "I cannot breathe." I see this one everywhere. So basically, Adam Cole is being billed at 6 feet tall. Zack Sabre Jr. is also billed at 6 feet tall. It's not even that big of a deal. I don't know why there's such big controversy, because you're like 50 years late. Wrestling always did that. The whole idea is that every wrestler, even if he's short, needs to look larger than life, you know, bigger than your average human being. They actually build Rey Mysterio at 5'6". No, AJ Styles is actually 5'8", Johnny Gargano is definitely not 5'10", he's like 5'6". This is Big Cass, and he's not 7 feet tall. You get the point. Randy Orton wants to make sure the show is over so he can stop selling and head to the back. Okay, gotta love Randy, I think I saw it. It was like in 2015. Goldberg giving Big Show the jackhammer in 1998. Still one of the most insane visuals in wrestling history. Yeah. Man, what an iconic moment. What an iconic moment. I could live Big Show, I'm sure. But your average human being, I doubt it, man. You couldn't. I'm just saying, you could not. Ever. Okay, look. And man. Bam. Oh my. I like how it was a bit more subtle back in the day. Like right now, you could see basically everyone doing this. You know, most people. But back then, it was really, really special. And I wish WWE saved these moments. Because now you see, you know, Cesaro or anyone body slamming the Big Show and stuff. I wish it was still that special. John Moxley says, "I'll tell you what pressure is. Pressure is having a 2-page script written by a 74-year-old madman." Yeah, man, a lot of stuff in the WWE doesn't make any sense. Especially stuff they gave to Dean Ambrose, John Moxley, because it was way too goofy. And I remember seeing Dean Ambrose before he won the WWE Championship. Rollins already won the championship. Reigns already won the championship. You're looking at Dean Ambrose and you're like, okay, this guy is not winning the championship. Breaking news. Dwayne The Rock Johnson is the new part owner of the XFL. 2020. Go home. You're drunk. What is even happening? Great news, I guess, but everything is so weird this year. What is even happening? I feel like I'm dreaming. 1 year ago last night, the greatest image in WWE history was taken. Yeah. Ouch. This is basically every wrestling YouTuber and me. It'd be like that sometimes. Everyone agreeing that NXT is the best WWE show and me. Everyone saying that Nia Jax is a good wrestler and I'm out of here. Oh man, I saw this one. Which one of you paid $400 for an Alexa Bliss cameo message just to ask her out?
Antonio, first I just wanted to say thank you so much for your message. It was so sweet of you to write me. I'm extremely flattered with your request. But unfortunately, I am seeing someone. But I know that there's someone out there for you. I know it's a little hard right now with everything going on with COVID and having to stay inside. So I hope
can't
you're
watch,
staying inside,
honestly.
Staying healthy.
Can't watch. Someone actually paid $400. $400. For $400, I would send you bikini pics of myself. Money well spent. Wow, what a loser. What an absolute loser. This is the saddest thing I've ever seen in my entire life. If you're watching my video, sorry. Don't watch my videos. Maybe I'm... Is it my fault? I kind of feel guilty. Even if it's not my fault, I feel guilty that a wrestling fan actually paid $400 to ask someone out on Cameo. You absolute effing loser. What a f***. loser. And okay, that's nice. Brilliant photo of the TNT champion. Well, the title looks like crap. Rusev tweeted, "We want to build new talent. Shane is back." Sums it up. Well, that is a stupid statement. Shane McMahon is not wrestling. He introduced a new show to build new talent. It's the complete opposite of what you're tweeting. I'm the one who always talks crap about wrestling, but sometimes you're reaching for it, and that wasn't even the case. Shane McMahon actually decided to push new talent. Picture of Michael Cole getting high with Snoop Dogg and The Godfather. Man, I love Michael Cole. Michael is my boy. I'd like to get drunk with Michael Cole. It's been 4 years since the greatest tweet in WWE history. I don't care who you are. Get out of my weight room. Hashtag Pokemon Go. Oh boy. Vince McMahon played Pokemon Go. Bret Hart looked great with every title he won. I mean, that's because he looked great in general. I believe Bret Hart had one of the best attires in wrestling history, especially back then in the 90s, 80s or whatever. He actually wore pink. That's badass. If I would be a wrestler, if I look different, I don't look badass. Well, maybe I do actually. Let's pretend I don't look badass, even though it's hard when you look at the muscles and stuff. Like, try to imagine, use imagination. If I looked even more badass, I would like to come out with some silly girly song like Barbie Girl or whatever, because there's nothing more badass than coming out with a stupid ass song and beating the living crap out of everyone. That's awesome. It's not really the case right here, but I mean, this guy looked absolutely phenomenal. Jeff Hardy as WWE champion, Matt Hardy as ECW champion. Cool and sad at the same time. Both children got a present from their mom. Guess which one mom loves more? Keith Lee when he signed with WWE. It's crazy how he looked kinda older here. Well, he shaved. That's what shaving does. You know? I have, like, the beard that I have right here, man, I look old. Man, I look so old right now. Like, I don't think you can see my face with all the beard action.
It's absolutely wild right here.
Young Roman Reigns posing proudly by his Trish Stratus cardboard cutout. Ah, you filthy. It reminds me of something. This is unrelated, but if you are over 12 and you're still obsessed with celebrities, you're a stan of divas or whatever, grow up. You're too old for this shit. Tajiri taking some time to mock his opponent mid-match. Okay, that's pretty awesome. CM Punk's face changing after seeing Mr. McMahon. It's a face you make when he tells you gotta get a needle up your ass. Matt Hardy accidentally deletes himself during his entrance. Yeah, one of the best moments in the WWE history. Absolutely loved it. Just CM Punk being honest. Who has the best diving elbow of all time? A. Randy Savage. B. Shawn Michaels. C. CM Punk. And D. Kairi Sane. CM Punk says, come on, this is a list I shouldn't be on. Just being honest, you know. I love CM Punk, but his diving elbow was always pretty meh. And I guess that's it for today's video. I actually really enjoyed it. If you want me to make it into series, I think PewDiePie is doing something like that. So it's not really an original idea, but now it's with wrestling. So it's different. Thank you for watching the video, The Great One. Peace, love, and hugs. Do not pay $400.